Good morning, friends. Rera, episode number 2. My personal opinion is that in Rera, there are certain loopholes, but still not much. And most of the Rera is in favor of the property buyers or investors. After Rera, there is one good thing, or my opinion about this is, all those builders who are good in providing good quality, right time possessions, proper plans, proper agreements, and handing over and conveyance deeds and everything, those won't be affected. But those builders, or they just started construction business on the basis of money and outsourced the construction activity to other contractors and exploited clients, that is been sealed, and such people will be out of business very soon. Also, many builders who used to execute development agreements or used to start the project earlier, and after certain time in midway they used to stop it or they used to sell it to the third party. Now it has been restricted by the RERA. Now builder won't be able to stop construction in any case. They have to complete the project. Second thing, they cannot sell the project to the third party and just move away. Now they have to take written permission, and that to be 70% of the purchaser should permit for this changes of ownership. So these are the different ways. Under this act, all the real estate agents should also be registered with the RERA authority, who will be selling builders' properties only. But one thing which I personally feel, that the real estate agents' practices and business is not covered under the RERA, which was supposed to be necessary in this act. Because second sale market or resale market of the real estate is very large market, and there are many brokers and many real estate agents in every house, every gully, every corner. There are so many real estate agents. They don't have any license to do business. They don't know the facts about the real estate market. They don't know the legalities about the real estate market. They are not literate even to do the business. They don't know the consumer rights. They don't know the title clearance, and still they are doing business and they are doing selling properties to the customers. There is wrong information provided by these real estate agents and brokers to the customer. They charge heavy commission and do not provide any service to the customer, which is not true and correct. Many brokers have also cheated owners and buyers both, and there is no legal restrictions on them. Customer or owner, they have to go to police station and file a registered complaint against them, which is again a lengthy process, and there is no relief provided under the RERA Act for such practices. My suggestion and opinion about this RERA, that the real estate agent's practices should be covered under the RERA, and a proper chalk down restrictions and rules and terms conditions should be saddled on the real estate brokers, and RERA authority should provide a proper license to every real estate agent after taking proper examination. The RERA Act, which has been introduced, is good news for the flat purchasers, but definitely not very good news for the construction industry, because many small and petty construction houses will have to wind up the business due to restrictions, and only big construction houses will sustain under this act. and many unauthorized firms, illegal business owners or construction houses that is majorly involved in exploitation and cheating will be closed down and shut down. In general, Rera is a good news for the purchasers, and I welcome it personally with one suggestion that Rera should also cover real estate agents' regulation and their activities under this law. Thank you. We are coming up with many such awareness videos. Please follow us and subscribe our channel on YouTube so that we will be helpful to you and you won't get cheated. Thank you.